What up, family? This your man, Jeff. Welcome back to my channel, Food Delivery Guru. All right, y'all. So over the last several months, I've gotten a lot of questions that some of you guys have sent me about going full time. And you guys wanted me to give y'all some pointers and some things and some suggestions whether or not it is still capable for you to, you know, essentially leave your full-time job or part-time job and do DoorDash and Grubhub, Postmates, whatever, full-time, okay? So let's go ahead and get into this video. I'm going to lay out the pertinent information that I believe that you're going to need in order to decide whether you want to make this a full-time gig for yourself. All right, so the number one thing that I believe that you have to do before going full-time trying to do gig work is that you got to have a change of mindset with how you think about, you know, a job versus being self-employed, okay? Now, realize that at a job, they take the taxes out for you. They help you set up your medical, to get medical and all that stuff taken out automatically. This is something as a self-employed person that you are going to now have to do for yourself. You are going to have to pay your taxes quarterly. You are going to have to, you know, secure medical and dental and vision and things like that for yourself. And if you're not by yourself, as well as for your family, you know, there are a lot of things that an employee will do that you are now going to have to do for yourself, including getting up and going to work, okay? Nobody's going to give you a schedule. Nobody's going to tell you when you got to be to work. All that is going to be on you now. So you have to have a change in mindset and understand that you are no longer an employee and that you are in business for yourself as a self-employed person. All right. So the second thing that I believe that you need to do before you decide to go full-time, okay? One, you need to be on multiple apps, not just one. You need to have as many apps that is in your area or part of the country as possible. And I recommend driving at least 6 months to a year for you to learn your area, where you're at, how busy it can be, how much money you can make, all of that, to really make a decision whether going full-time, doing gig work is going to be for you, okay? If you just try to jump into this thing and you don't know your area and it's not really that busy and you don't really have a good estimate of how much money you can make versus your part-time job or whatever full-time job you're working, it ain't even worth it, okay? You might as well not even consider it. Drive at least a minimum of 6 months in your area on all the apps that you are running to learn the apps, learn the businesses, learn how much money you can make before you decide to go full time. All right, so this is number three. And, you know, a part of this, you probably could have put this tidbit as like part of number one, but I wanted to kind of relate all this information, so I'm classifying it as number three. But, you know, in order to go full time doing this stuff, you got to like to drive. Okay, you can't be getting irritated at the people that don't drive out there. So, you know, liking to drive, you know, for long hours of the day, you gotta like to be able to do that. Okay, you gotta learn how to entertain yourself. All right, listen to music, watch YouTube videos like I do, all of the above. But the most important thing, when regards to your vehicle, okay, if you are going to go full-time, you need to have a very reliable gas-saving vehicle, okay? Something that is going to get you good gas mileage. I recommend a hybrid vehicle. That's why I have two vehicles. One is a Chevy Volt 2017, which is electric, and it will stay on electric as long as I keep it charged. If once my electric's gone, it automatically switches to gas. Then I have my 2018 Chevy Bolt, which is full electrical, okay? So, you know, having a reliable vehicle that gets good gas mileage is a plus, okay? If you have a beater that doesn't get a whole lot of gas mileage, that's going to cost you, or, you know, cause you to have a lot of maintenance behind it, you might not want to go full-time right now until you get your vehicle game up, okay? Now, notice I said that I got a second vehicle, okay? And the reason why I went out and got a second vehicle is because this is how I make my living, okay? So, if my vehicle goes down for maintenance, okay, I need to be able to have a vehicle that I can still go make money in, okay? So, I look at my other car, which is the full electric, I look at that car as, you know, the house car. You know, for me to go run my errands and do my other stuff. I don't have commercial insurance on that vehicle. I have the commercial insurance on my Chevy Volt, which is the main vehicle that I use. Now, I might use it 1 or 2 days out of the week. But, you know, my main vehicle is my Chevy Volt. That is the one that I put the majority of my miles on, and that is the one that I have, you know, my commercial insurance on. So, if you all don't have a good, reliable vehicle, or even a second vehicle that you can, you know, run your errands in, or that could, you know, if you have to get your main vehicle fixed, that you can still go out and make money, you might want to consider that before you go full time. All right, last but not least, insurance, okay? And I'm not just talking about car insurance, okay? You are an independent contractor. You are self-employed, okay? So you got to make sure, one, you have the proper car or vehicle insurance, okay? Me personally, I have commercial insurance through Geico. Yes, it is very expensive, but I need to make sure that I'm covered 100%. I don't want to be looking at no fine prints. I know that I'm covered for anything that happens to me and my vehicle. Make sure you have proper medical insurance. Nothing like getting into an accident and not having medical insurance to cover any of that stuff, okay? Also, unemployment insurance, okay? Make sure that if something happens to you, if you did get into an accident and you can't go to work, that you are going to be able to get, you know, or have some insurance that is going to help supplement what you are losing while you are recovering. And there's a ton of businesses out there. What's his name? Can't even think of his name right now. Just slipped my tongue. But the main DoorDash guy, Bentley. There we go. Bentley Coop. He does advertise them. There's companies out there that if you get deactivated from an app, they will help you supplement, you know, if you're on their platform. They help you with lawyers, you know, help you get, you know, reinstated, things like that. If, you know, but there's tons of stuff out there. You got to make sure, because this is your business, you are self-employed, you got to make sure that you are covered in those areas, okay, before you go full-time. All right, if you are not ready to be covered in those areas, then you are not ready to go full time. So, you guys put in the comments below, you know, y'all can add as much as you want. Maybe I missed something. Like I said, I'm just trying to put in the pertinent things that I feel are the most and main things before you decide to go full time. There's going to be a lot of other little things there that I didn't talk about. Feel free to put them in the comments. I hope that answered, you know, those that sent me those emails. I hope this answered your questions. And feel free, if you guys have any other questions, just put them in the comments. You know, I try to get to y'all questions as soon as possible within the day. Because I'm out here driving like y'all, and I got 3 different, you know, email accounts, and sometimes I don't get the email in time. So, anyway, I hope this helped you guys, and as I say, y'all drive safe out there, make that money.